Have you ever opened Obsidian only to find your notes missing or corrupted? It happened to me, and it was not pretty. Syncing my vault did not help me, my backup system did. So in this video, I'm going to show you the exact differences between synchronizing and backing up, your top synchronizing options, including free tools, and an effortless backup system you can set and forget so your vault stays safe, whatever happens. Quick heads up, some parts of this video get a little technical. I know this is not everybody's cup of tea, but stick with me, because it's important. And to make things a bit better, I have got good news from today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is packed with classes on just about every creative topic you can imagine, from writing and painting to photography, productivity, and even AI. Personally, I have just started a Blender class. Blender is a 3D modeling program with my son, who needs it for a school project. So it's not just educational, we're actually having fun learning it together. And if Blender is not your thing, don't worry. Skillshare has something for everyone. Want to get crafty, learn an instrument, or dive into the world of digital art? You will find it there. Still on the fence? Here is the kicker. The first 500 people to use my link in the description or scan the QR code get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare plus 20% of their first payment. So why not give it a try? Check out Skillshare today and unlock your next creative adventure. Most Obsidian users think, if I can see my vault on my phone and my PC, I am safe. But that's only half true, and it can set you up for a nasty surprise. Let me give you a real example. I once accidentally deleted an entire folder. Within seconds, it vanished everywhere. My phone, my laptop, all gone. When I noticed it much later, my heart sank. If I hadn't set up a backup, every node in this folder would have been lost for good. And here's why. Synchronizing keeps your vault identical on every device. Add a node on your phone, it pops up on your laptop. But if you delete something by mistake, that deletion synchronizes everywhere as well. Backup is different. It's like having insurance for your nodes. If disaster strikes, corruption, deletion, even a synchronizing glitch, you can roll back and get everything as it was. Think of it this way. Sync is like a mirror. Whatever you do in one place instantly appears everywhere else. Backup is like having a time machine. If you mess up, you can travel back and restore things to how they were before. That's why you need both. So let's look at your main syncing options. Obsidian's own service and two free alternatives. Most people just want the nodes to magically appear everywhere. But the way you synchronize your Obsidian vault can save you hours of headaches or cost them. Whenever someone asks me how to sync the vault, I always respond with the same question. Do you want plug-and-play convenience, or are you willing to tinker a bit to save money? Let's break down your three main options. First, there is Obsidian Sync. This is like taking the express train. You buy your ticket, hop on, and you are whisked straight to your destination, fast, reliable, and effortless. You pay for the speed and comfort, and everything just works. Then there is Sync Thing. Think of this as building your own bike from scratch. It takes some tinkering and technical confidence to get all the parts working together properly, but once you have got it assembled, you are in total control. One viewer told me they loved the freedom Sync Thing gave them, even if the setup was a bit of a challenge at first. And then there is cloud storage, like Dropbox, Google Drive, or OneDrive. Imagine sending yourself letters through the mail. It's familiar and easy if you already use it, but sometimes the mail gets delayed, lost, or you end up with confusing duplicates. These services can struggle with rapid or simultaneous changes, so you will need to keep an eye out for mix-ups. One quick note on these conflicts. If two devices edit the same node at once, you will see a conflict file. Don't panic. Obsidian saves both versions so you can merge changes safely and with full control. But even perfect sync cannot protect you from every disaster. Next, I will show you how to add real backup protection so your nodes are safe no matter what. Here's the scary part. Even with perfect sync, one wrong move can wipe out everything. It happened to me, well, almost. A corrupted file got synchronized everywhere and suddenly had nothing to roll back to. This is why backups are just as important as a good synchronizing mechanism. Think of backups as your safety net. If sync is like having a dance partner who mirrors your every move, backup is the crash mat that saves you if you both trip and fall down. You have two main ways to set up backups. Plugin-based backups inside of Obsidian is one option. The most popular online backup plugin is Obsidian Git. It saves versions of your nodes over time, so you can rewind to a previous snapshot if something goes wrong. Another option is Remotely Save, which combines synchronizing with version history for extra peace of mind. For local backups, there is a simple plugin called, well, Local Backup. It automatically saves your entire vault as a zip file whenever you open or close Obsidian, or even at set intervals that you can choose and define. A link to all the plugins is in the description below, of course. If you don't want to use community plugins or want to be even safer, there is Obsidian's built-in file recovery plugin. This core plugin takes automatic snapshots of your nodes at regular intervals, so you can restore previous versions. It usually works well, but in the case I mentioned earlier, it didn't. So do not rely on it alone. And then you have the option to set up automated local backups outside of Obsidian. Tools like Free File Sync let you copy your vault to another folder, drive, or even a NAS, Network Area Storage. This is basically just a drive connected to your local network, which you can access from your PC. Set it up once and it runs in the background, only copying new or changed files, a so-called differential backup, which makes it very fast and efficient. You can also schedule backups for times when you're not working, and you can even set up different backup jobs for different folders. After all, maybe it's not just your Obsidian vault that you want to save and backup. So here's the bigger picture. Synchronizing keeps your devices in step, and backups make sure nothing is lost forever. Put them together, and your vault is both flexible and safe. So here's the bottom line. Sync alone is like locking your doors, but backup is your spare key. You need both for true peace of mind. That way, your nodes aren't just everywhere you need them to be, they're also safe if something goes wrong. Here is the simplest system I recommend for most Obsidian users. Choose one sync option like Obsidian Sync, which starts at around $4 per month, for plug-and-play reliability, or you can of course also pick a free alternative if you don't mind tinkering a bit. And pair this one sync option with one backup method, either a plugin like Obsidian Git or Local Backup, or an external tool like Free File Sync running quietly in the background. This combo protects you from almost anything, from accidental deletions to a total device meltdown. And if you're feeling extra cautious or paranoid, you can even combine multiple methods for ultimate security. In the next chapter, I will show you my current setup where I'm doing just that. I never worry about losing my notes, even if my laptop dies, my phone gets lost, or I make a huge mistake. Here's exactly how I protect my Obsidian vault across Windows and Android, using layers of armor for my data. First layer, Obsidian Sync. I use Obsidian Sync on my Windows PC, my laptop, and my Android phone. This keeps my vault up to date everywhere I work, so I always have the latest notes on every device. Second layer, quick rollbacks inside of Obsidian. With the File Recovery Core plugin, I can take snapshots, like a Time Machine save point, every 2 minutes and keep a week's worth of history. If I mess something up, I can rewind instantly. The Local Backup plugin automatically zips up my entire vault, once when I quit Obsidian, and then every 2 hours while it is open. It keeps 20 days of daily backups, each with a timestamp, stored on an external SSD, so if my PC breaks, I still have the backup. Third layer, automated local backups outside of Obsidian. I use Free File Sync to create two types of backup jobs. One is a daily mirror to an external SSD. This is an exact copy of my vault. Add, update, or delete a file in the vault, and the backup matches it exactly. Second, I have weekly updates to my NAS, the network area storage I mentioned earlier. This is a storage drive on my home network, like a private cloud if you want. This backup only adds or updates files. It never deletes them. So even if I mess up my vault, my NAS still has the old versions. I automate everything with Windows Task Scheduler. Two simple scheduled tasks run the daily and weekly backups for me, so I never have to think about them. And here's why this works. Obsidian Sync keeps everything current across my devices. File Recovery catches small mistakes very fast and lets me go back. Local Backup gives me Time Machine snapshots. And the external hard disk or SSD mirror is my rapid recovery. The NAS is my last line of defense if disaster strikes. Think of these as layers of armor. Each one catches a different kind of disaster. And best of all, aside from Obsidian Sync, all my backups are free and totally private. Everything happens locally on my machine, my SSD, or my NAS. If this sounds like a lot, don't worry. You can start with just one backup layer and add more as you get comfortable and if you think you need it, perhaps you don't. As mentioned, this was just an overview. In my next video, I will walk you through, step by step, exactly how to set up this system so you can copy it straight into your own workflow. If you want to follow along, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. Now you know how to keep your notes safe. But how can you create notes that are worth saving in the first place? Tricky question. Well, watch this video to learn how to use the Templater plugin to build smarter templates, and you can even download them for free if you want to save time. I will leave the link to them in the description, of course.